God's really been, well, I'll say in the beginning of the year, Pastor told all of us to choose 5 things that we wanted God to restore for us this year. And my mom and I have been okay for some time, but we haven't been close. But she wasn't one of my 5, actually. God's been working on all those other things. And kind of behind the scenes, he's also been working on that. And what I've come to realize is that's greater than all of the other things that I've even asked for. It's amazing. My mom, is the one thing I've wanted from her my whole life is just that unconditional love from a parent. The knowing that my life encourages her and pleases her, and just that special bond between a mother and a daughter. I've loved my mom deeply my whole life. And our conversations, it's just been a miracle. Our conversations this whole year have been open like that, where she's shared her heart with me and told me that she's proud of me. My mom actually said to me once that that I'm the woman that she's always wanted to be.
Wow.
And that, it's amazing, it's a miracle. And I got to see my mom last weekend. She asked me to come. I think she kind of knew something was going on with her. And it was just amazing, it was beautiful the whole weekend. I got to serve her and talk to her and encourage her. And we had so many moments of just good conversation and loving words. And it's really a miracle for me. And I'm so blessed. I really am.
Somebody say amen. So with the divine restoration, God restoring her and her mother back the way it's supposed to be. Somebody say amen. Come on, share yours quickly.
Talk about divine restoration. I've been estranged from my family for over a decade. Mother, father, 4 brothers, aunts, uncles, grandparents, some of them over a decade. And when Pastor had said this is the year of restoration and divine open doors, I thought, it's not going to happen for me. You don't know my family. You don't know that. You don't know, you know? And, you know, it was praying and the word kept coming up. It's even in my devotionals. And within 14 or 15 days, January 14th or 15th, I had already been contacted by 7 family members by the 15th. Since then, I have seen my 2 of my brothers face to face. One was just a few days ago. A sister-in-law, my niece, and just last weekend, my father. So I even have a picture. So talk
in
about.
Fact, she actually sent me a picture.
Yeah,
I'm like, father.
Like, this is my spiritual daddy. I'm like, but this is my father, like my actual one, you know. So divine restoration and open doors. This house is powerful. I am so grateful for this word. I'm so grateful for this house. I'm so grateful for this covering. And even, you know, when there's lack, the family of God fills in for that too, you know. But God is awesome. He's really awesome.
Somebody say amen. The divine restoration. Amen. So I don't know about you, but tap into that word. Whatever the enemy has stolen from you, it could be family, it could be whatever it is. Some of us mostly think it's material things. It's more than material. Whatever it is that you have lost, 2015 will not finish unless everything you have lost is restored back to you. Somebody shout, amen! So, Apostle, most have been in my life for the last, oh my goodness, 2-3 decades. And it has affected my life in such a marvelous manner. So today is the bringing the word of God to us. I'm going to encourage you to open your heart. God has used him mightily all over the globe. He has ministries all over the continent of this world. And I would like you to open your heart today, because if you open your hearts to what you're about to hear tonight, it will bless you. It will prepare you to your place of destiny. And you will understand what it means to have a father of your father in the house. Somebody say amen. Amen. So I would like to introduce to you this morning my father, Apostle Moses Grandeur. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, sir. Well, praise the Lord. How many of you are happy you are alive? You are alive. Hallelujah. It's so good to be back here in Allentown to be with my son and the queen of his kingdom. And with all of you, what a joy. Now, before you take your seat, I'd like you to look for 7 people and tell them. Now, let's repeat this together before you go around to tell them. Say with me, I am an irresistible magnet. I attract all that is mine by divine right. Say it again. Say, I am an irresistible magnet. I attract all that is mine by divine right. Now go around, tell 7 people, I am an irresistible magnet. Go ahead and tell them, I attract all that is mine by divine right. Do you really believe it? How many of you know that everything you ought to be was programmed before you were born? I mean, everything you ought to be was programmed by God before you were born. There are no accidents in your life. All things still work together for good. Can I get 2 good amen? Amen. It's so nice to be here in the house. How many of you actually know what is called magnet? Do you know what it is? Have you ever seen a magnet? Now, when I was a kid, we used to use magnet to play. Are you still with me? So we put needles and razor blades and metal on the ground, and we just move the magnet, and all those metal come to the magnet. The magnet doesn't go to them. They come to the magnet. Are you with me? Even metals that were under the sand come to the magnet. I have good news for you. Between now and December, as you move, everything that is yours by divine right is coming. Come on, you believe it, clap your hands and celebrate that. It's coming. Your promotion is coming. Your new job is coming. Your testimony is coming. Your marriage is coming. Your new car is coming. Your new house is coming. Your new position is coming. Somebody said they are coming. Yeah. Thank God. Well, if you notice, when I came the last time, I was slimmer than this. Now, the first lady has loaded me with food and I've added so much. Why not give the first lady 5 kisses for me? Mwah, 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 mwah. Thank you, first lady. What a blessing. You are a blessing. You are a reward. We love you. We thank God for you. Thank you for being the wife of my son, the mother of our children, and the queen of his kingdom. How many of you believe that Essie Duke is a genuine man of God? I know that you love him. I know that you believe him. But it's about time you go out there and announce him.
You see, the Samaritan woman said to them, come see a man. She didn't say, come see a God. There are too many fake around there. It's about time you introduce your neighbors, your friend, your colleague to a genuine man of God. Join me, let's celebrate my son, Dr. Essie Duke. Celebrate him. I'm going to let the wife give him a peck and a kiss. Go ahead and do that for the church. Do that now. A peck and a kiss. And a kiss. And a kiss. Good. Only a grandpa can do that. Thank you. You may be seated. I love this church myself. Just like you do. Wonderful church. Spirit of God moving. Liberty, joy, excitement. This is not an American church. This is Holy Ghost church. And I bring you special greetings from my baby, my queen, my sweet potato pie. My ice cream. My hot chocolate. Hallelujah. The mother of my children and grandchildren, my sweet potato pie, my private amusement park, my tourist attraction, Mama Bishop Angel Grandeur. Would you celebrate my wife? Praise God. You may be seated. I like to teach you a song, but let me appreciate the sound, the sound, the technician, the camera people, the choir, and the leadership of this church. I really appreciate you. You are making me very proud, and I'm happy about that. Thank you. Thank you. Really thank you. You know, Dr. Essie Duke, when I came on that first Sunday and I raised the money for the land, for the building, I also gave $500. And I told you how God blew my mind and gave me an automatic harvest when I traveled to Chester. I'm telling you, I'm blessed. I want you to make good your pledge. You see, make good your pledge. I tell people every time, don't make a pledge if you don't mean it. Because Ecclesiastes chapter 5 says, when we make pledges, and we, now I know it's 3 months, but it's better to put God under pressure. It is better for you not to wait for 3 months. Now, trust me, ask Dr. Essie Duke, when I made my pledge, I had my Visa card, no, but I like the way, where's the lady? You call it, what do you call it? Plastic. You see, I came with plastic. And I have $5,000 in the plastic. And I was shopping and buying stuff for my wife. And then I made the pledge and I told Essie Duke, please, let's get this thing quickly out of the plastic before I begin to use it to buy something. And we went, we got the money. And I didn't know that my plastic expired. So we just got the money out and then it got expired. But I tell you what, I have shopped more than what I expected. Money has been coming from everywhere because I obeyed God. Because I obeyed God. Slap somebody and say, obey God. Thank you, Father. Obey God. I have my granddaughter, Ola, all the way from, what's the name of that, your place? Is it, you are not in Allentown, are you? Allentown? look at this girl. This girl I used to carry like this. She's all grown. Let's give her a good welcome and her auntie. Thank you for coming to join us today. Thank you. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. His name is higher above all the name. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. Somebody sing, his name is above all the names. His name is Jesus. Sing. His name is Lord. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. Sing it one more time now. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. His name is higher. Hallelujah. Above all the name. His name is, oh, I feel the presence of the Holy Ghost. His name is, let's sing it again. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. Lift your hands, sing it now. His name is higher above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. His name is higher. Hallelujah. Above all the names. His name is Jesus. His name is Lord. You have your Bible. I'd like you to take it up. Let's make our confession. How many of you believe that the best is ahead of you? The worst is behind you. You believe that? All right, let's make our confession. Say, this my Bible is the word of God. It says, whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Say, I am born of God. I am an overcomer. I have victory on every side. I am graced by God. I cannot be disgraced in life. In Jesus' name. Somebody give God a big amen. Now sit down and break your Bible to Philippians. Philippians is in the New Testament. And just in case you don't know where it is, go to Genesis. Keep flipping your Bible, you will get there before we close. Philippians chapter number 2. You know, Dr. S. Duke, I tell people, don't come to church if you don't believe God. It doesn't make sense. Don't waste your time. Come believing. Come to church believing. He that cometh to God must believe. I've not started to read my scripture yet. I believe that there are some of you that God wants to help today. Can I get an amen? Amen. There are some conditions that expires today. Some situation expires today. Some long-standing condition expires today. Can I get a good covenant? Amen.
Amen.
Expires today. And when your driver license expires, you don't use it. It doesn't work. When my visa card expires, I couldn't use it. There are some conditions, sicknesses, diseases that expires today. Do you know today's date? What's today's date? July 12th. There are things that have been around you that you will look for, you will never find them anymore. They're gone. Philippians chapter number 2. I want to verse number 5 from my Bible. It says, are you there? Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men. And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every what? Oh, I can't hear you well. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things on earth and things underneath the earth. That every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. I want to preach today on a message titled, It's About Name. It's About Name. I want to teach, I want to preach, I want to mix everything together because today is my last time here until 2016. I'm not sure. Oh, okay. For this trip. Say it with me, it's about name. Say it again, it's about name. What is in a name? Number one, name is identity. Ma'am, what's your name?
Gina.
If you were in Walmart and there was so much crowd of people moving and you heard that name, what would happen to you?
I'd know they were calling me.
Name is identity. Name represent personality. Name carries power. Oh boy. I come again. Please, I don't want you to miss this. Name means what? Identity. Say it with me. Identity. Say it again, church. Name represent personality. Say it. Name carries power. Every time you call the name of the devil, it carries the power of evil. And every time you call the name of God, Jesus, Holy Ghost, it carries the power for good. Write this down. Nothing is alive without a name. Nothing is alive without a name. In fact, when a man dies, he loses his name. When a man dies and is laid, they don't call him James, they say the body, the corpse. Yes. Nothing lives without a name. And there is no name without power. There is influence. I'm not going to take your time, son, but please follow me. That is the reason why you cannot bear every name. When Jabez was called by the mother, Jabez, even though Jabez was a doctor, life was bad. Now you need to go study your Bible. Jabez was not a pushover. Jabez was a doctor. But the name plagued his life. Every time they call him Jabez, the name means sorrow. And Jabez called upon God, and God reversed it in the realm of the spirit. And when God reversed it, a city was built and named after him. I thought you wanted to clap your hands. Go ahead and do that. Abraham. His name was Abraham. Abraham means high father. High father. God looked at him and said, I changed your name from high father to Abraham, father of many nations. All over the Bible. So if you are in this house and your name is Spoon, change it. There are people whose name is Wood. Wood. Wood, not a tree, self. Wood is not a tree. Wood is a dead tree. Don't bear any kind of name. Are you still here? Preach to your neighbor, say it's about name. Jesus changed the name of Caiaphas to Peter. Changed his name. He changed the name of Sarah to Sarai. All over the Bible, he changed the name of Jacob to Israel. Thank you, Jesus. What's going on with my sister? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I lay hands on you. And I speak over your destiny. Whatever it is that was working against your life, the anointing of the Holy Ghost begin to correct it right now. The name of Jesus. Something. Oh boy. This service is going to be wow. But please follow me. Follow me. Name. Now let me go back to my test. Quickly. The Bible said, let this mind be in you. There is a mind you need to serve God. I don't want to deal with the name. Let me leave the name for a moment. The mind. You need the right mind to worship God. And what do you need in the mind? Humility. Selflessness. Service. Obedience. You cannot serve God if you don't know how to serve God through a man. You see, Elsie Duke is a young man. But for you to be blessed in this commission, you must receive him as your spiritual father. Come on. If you receive him as your brother, you won't get the best. If you see him as your colleague, you won't get the best. You must come into this house with the mind to serve. You must find that, what can I do to add value to this work? What can I do to increase and increase and increase this work? What can I contribute? Humility, selflessness, service, obedience. Are they following me? Take it from me if you want to write it. No man is greater than his mind. You are a product of your mind. So when you come to church with the right mind, you attract divine visitation. Oh boy. I have been preaching for 33 years. And I tell you what, I will not come here and tell you something that is not in the word. The Bible says Jesus did not make himself of reputation with God. How many of you know that Jesus is God? But he thought it not robbery to be equal with God. In other words, he said, God, I know we are equal, but I bring myself down. Is deliberate humility, deliberate obedience, deliberate service, deliberate selflessness. You know, some of you have never been to Africa, so you don't know what I'm talking about, but the closest culture to the word of God is in Africa. The closest culture. Because here you have democracy. In Africa, many years back, we have kingdom. So we know how to relate to those in authority. Now, if AC Duke comes back to Nigeria to be in my church to preach in the hotel room, we will send him protocols. Did you hear what I said? Men, well-dressed, well-placed, with three cars, to go get one person. That's how we treat people. Nobody will allow S. Duke to carry his Bible. They will take it from him. Now, when you treat a man of God like that, you attract the grace of God. You attract the power of God. You attract the anointing of God. You trigger the power. Somebody, go ahead and shout yes. Let this mind be in you, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself. It's deliberate. Church is closed and people are not just rushing home because they want to be sure that pastor is all right. Pastor, is there any more thing you want me to do? God, what can I do in your house? The Bible said, because he did that, move to the next verse. Be found in fashion as a man, he did what? Oh boy, come and talk to me. Humility is not humiliation.
Amen.
The Bible said, God resists the proud. Now come, let me show you what it is. Come. That's the book of James. It said, God resists the proud, but give grace to the humble. You know what that means? When a man comes to church, a woman comes to church, and you look at your reputation, you look at your position, you look at your age, and you don't look at God and the servant of God, and you are proud, the Bible said, God resists you. Come and pass. Come. God resists you. You want to make progress, but God is in front. He said, but he giveth more grace to the humble. He lift up the humble. When people put themselves down, God lift them. Now, the same is true about men. If you work in an office with your boss and you are a humble, selfless person, you stand the chance to be promoted. Am I right? But when you become arrogant and proud, and your boss look at you and say, well, you are due for promotion, but I'm not going to promote you. Hallelujah. Am I doing good, son? I'm going to close in a moment. Now the Bible said, and being found in the fashion, as he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore? That's where I'm going. Because of this, God have highly exalted him. I pray for you that divine exaltation will come on your life. I pray for you that the hand of God will raise you. I pray for you that grace will lift you. I pray for you that the anointing will raise you. I pray for you that the power of God will raise you. Somebody stand up and shout, yes, 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 yes. Now sit down. Thank you. Sometimes I do this in church. God have highly exalted him and given him a name. Somebody says about the name. That at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Of this in heaven, of things in the earth, of things under the earth. I want to preach. There is nothing challenging you that does not have a name. There is nothing confronting your life that does not have a name. If it has no name, it's not living. I want to take you to the word of God. Are you ready for this? First Samuel 17. Please go with me. Let me close with this. Let me see how I can close. First Samuel 17. Oh, blessed be God. Preach to me thrice. It's about a name. Preach it again. First Samuel 17 and verse number 42. First Samuel 17, verse number 42. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Somebody wave your hand to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. My sister over there, please come. Come to me. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I hear in my spirit the door you have been knocking is about to open. I don't know what it is, but you have been asking for something very unique. God says it's about to open. Take it from my hand. Take it from my hand. Clap your hands if you want. Come here, sir. Thank you. I hear in my spirit the delay is over. The delay is over. The delay is over. I don't know exactly what you have been believing God for and you have not gotten it. I hear the delay is over. Put your hands in my hand. Put it, take it, take it, take it. The delay is over. The delay is over. Somebody wave your hand to the heavens. Give God some praise if you will. Thank you. My sister over there, come. You. I hear in my spirit the questions have received answer. The question has received answer. The question has received. There is this thing you have thought about, you have wondered about. God said to me, the question is over. The question is over. The question is over. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Take it. Take it. Take it. The question is over. The question is over. Celebrate God if you will. Celebrate God if you will. The question is over. Oh boy. Now, I want to paint a picture. I want to do like an artist. I want to paint a picture for you. We're not going to read, but just put it there. The Bible talk about how that Israel had a battle with the Philistines. Am I correct? Israel had war with the Philistines. And Israel mobilized all their army to battle. And the Philistines mobilized to battle. They came to the battlefront, and one man called Goliath stood out of the army and said, "Give me a man." to fight with me. Let not everybody get into a fight. If I defeat him, Israel lose. If he defeats me, then you win. The Bible said, for 40 days, say with me 40. For 40 days, Israel could not find answer. Israel could not find answer. And I said to God, why? In fact, the Bible said, Israel, the army, were hiding. They were hiding in caves. And I found out that Goliath came with a name. He came to the battle with the name of the God of the Philistine. And that paralyzed all Israel. They couldn't do anything for 40 days. They came with weapons, they came with gun, they came with bow, arrow, but they couldn't do anything to a man that came with a name. Then a young boy also came with a name. The Bible said, and Goliath cursed David in the name of his God. And David spoke back to Goliath in the name of his God. David said to Goliath, you come against me in your powers, your arrows, your bow, your sword, but I come against you in the name of the God, the Lord God of Israel. Who told you that a sling and a stone can kill Goliath? Read your Bible. He was dressed with metal all over. Check your Bible. He had a helmet of brass. He had a shield. There was no place. But David came with a name. And threw the stone in the name, and the name took over the stone. Find a place in Goliath, put him down. Somebody say, it's about the name. God has given Jesus a name above the name of cancer. Cancer is a name. Stroke is a name. Paralysis is a name. Growth is a name. Migraine is a name. Fibroid is a name. But the name of Jesus is above every other name. That at the name of Jesus, every disease must bow, every sickness must bow, every pain must bow. Somebody shout hallelujah. I hear in my spirit that name is making way for you. Proverbs 18:10, he said, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous you are safe in the name. You are protected in the name. You are blessed in the name. You are lifted in the name. You are having your breakthrough in the name. You are testifying in the name. You are having your breakthrough in the name. Scream the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Sister, close your Bible. Stand to your feet. Lift your hands up. There's power in that name. A new door is opening by the name. The name of Jesus is a key to the supernatural. Somebody scream Jesus. Jesus. Beginning from today, you will see the wonder of the name of Jesus. Wishes are conquered by the name of Jesus. Demons in the river, in the ocean are conquered by the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are in this place. You have often had a dream. It has repeated itself over 1, 2, 3 times. You had this dream and you find yourself like you are falling down the cliff. Like you are dropping down from a high place. Where are you? You find yourself in a dream like you were dropping, like you were falling. Where are you? Where are you? Come here. Give the Lord praise. God is a lifter. He will not let you fall. I correct that dream in the realm of the spirit. No more will you experience backwardness. No more will you experience a fall. By the authority that is in the name of Jesus, I lay hands on you and I release you to the top. My goodness. Oh, thank you. I hear in my spirit someone else has had dream more than twice and he's lost. He's lost. He can't find where he's going. He's lost. You lost. You find yourself in a dream. You didn't know where you were going. You got lost. You got lost. You got lost. God says to me, I want to give you direction. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? You find yourself lost in your dream? Oh, stretch your hand towards this young man. This is not me. This is God. Lift your hands to heaven. Receive the anointing for direction. Never lost. Never lost. Give the Lord praise if you will. Somebody said the name of Jesus is powerful. It's more powerful than every other name. Say it again. The name of Jesus is powerful than every other name. Somebody shout yes. The name. We cast out devils in the name. Goliath got defeated by the name. It's about name. It's about name. Learn to use the name more often. Learn to use that name more often. I told Dr. S. Duke a few days ago, someone in Nigeria couldn't sleep because evil spirit of the dead were terrifying her. She couldn't sleep. She could feel the dead all over the room. And they called me. And I lift up the name of Jesus. I prayed and I said to her, go back to bed. She went back to bed and slept like a baby. There's power in the name of Jesus. There is answer in the name of Jesus. There is deliverance in the name of Jesus. There is healing in the name of Jesus. There is prosperity in the name of Jesus. Stand up, sir. What's your name? Daniel, come. Open your two hands. You will not only see money, but you will retain money. Money will stay in your hand. Money will stay in your hand. You will not only make money, see money, you will have money. Give the Lord praise. Preach to me. There is something about the name.
Something about the name. Amen.
Use that name against any devil. If they say to you, you can't make success, use that name and break the power of darkness. I want to minister to some of you. But before I do, go with me quickly in God's word, very quickly. Oh, thank you, Jesus. John chapter number 14 and verse 14. John 14 and verse 14. If you believe God, say, I believe God. Let me hear you say it again. Help is coming. What did he say? Everybody, let's read it. If ye ask, how many things? How many things? Do you have anything you want to ask? Do you have anything in your life you want to ask? He said, I will do it. Now we've never done this before. Everybody move to the altar. You got it. Ask God from your heart. Here you get it. You have it. Jesus. Here you have it. You ask, you have it. God cannot lie. God cannot lie. God cannot lie. Please, Dr. S. Duke, help me out. God cannot lie. Jesus, you ask, you got it. Now we thank you right now for today. We give you praise for what you have done. And we bless you for everything that's taking place, for the deliverance, for the healing. Lord, we give you praise. We pray that everyone who have received from you today would maintain and keep everything they have received. In the name of Jesus. Say, I am blessed. Everything I received today, I keep it. In the name of Jesus, all the blessings, all the healing, all the deliverance I received in this house today is mine, and I keep it in the name of Jesus. I will not lose it. I keep it in the name of Jesus. Blessing is mine. Prosperity is mine. Healing is mine. Deliverance is mine. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Give a clap to the Lord.